We are going to take a shaky input video like this and turn it into an immersive 3D rendering. We build upon neural radiance field, or NeRF. NeRF optimizes a barometric representation as a function that maps 3D location and view direction to density and colors. We can then use barometric rendering to render a pixel. This rendering process is differentiable, allowing us to optimize the thing representations by minimizing the reconstruction errors from rendering all rays. This works great for synthetic objects since they can easily be represented in a bounded domain. Real things are a little bit tricky because the images contain objects that are close and far away from the camera. Luckily, when all the cameras are facing similar directions, we can use normalized device coordinates to warp the space so that they become bounded. For 360 unbounded things where the camera points inward, MinNeRF 360 proposes a contraction operation to smoothly warp the space into a bounded domain. But how do we model a large-scale things captured in a long trajectory? We can still apply the contraction technique. The rendered result looks fine initially, but the quality decays as we move away from the center. Our idea is to create multiple local radiance fields along the trajectory. This allows us to handle very long sequence while maintaining high quality reconstruction and preview synthesis results. One remaining issue is the camera poses. Most radiance field methods assume that the camera poses can be reliably estimated via structure from motion algorithms. However, structure from motion algorithms are often not robust. When they fail, we don't have the poses to work with. We can jointly estimate the camera poses together with the radiance field. This works for a short video, but fail miserably for a longer video. To address this, we progressively estimate the camera poses in the local radiance field framework. The local and progressive estimations offers greater robustness when handling casual videos. For rendering, we blend the results from adjacent radiance fields to create seamless transitions. Let's take a look at some results.